sensors play a crucial role in ensuring the safety and efficiency of railway transportation systems. Today, we are delving into the heart of railway safety, the axle counter. We'll explore how this crucial track sensor works. Commonly, it is often installed at the entry and exit points of block sections, near the level crossing and before the switch point. This device is secured to the base of the rail, using nuts and bolts. The transmitter housing is fixed to the base on the outer side of the rail, while the receiver housing is mounted on the inner side. The transmitter heads and receiving heads are connected with junction box via cables. Ultimately, they are linked to the evaluator box. This device operates based on the magnetic field and requires electricity to create the magnetic field. Specifically, it needs a small amount of electricity, which is supplied by a small DC voltage. Power is needed for two purposes. Firstly, to supply voltage ranging from 24 volts DC to 60 volts DC for indoor equipment connected to the evaluator box, and secondly, to provide a constant voltage of 70 volts DC for the external operation of up to 5 counting heads. The transmitter and receiver coils generate two magnetic flux paths, diameter 1 and diameter 2, near the rail. Under normal conditions, when no wheel is passing over the track, these two magnetic fluxes pass through the receiver coil in opposite directions. The magnetic path for these two fluxes offers different levels of resistance. That means, with the magnetic flux can flow through the path varies. In this context, resistance implies the degree to which the material or medium impedes the flow of magnetic flux. When a wheel passes over the track, the screening effect of the wheel flange reduces the flux diameter 1 to a value nearly equal in magnitude to that of flux diameter 2. As a result, these two fluxes cancel each other out, causing the induced voltage in the receiver to decrease significantly. During this time, the double wheel detector's sensing range generates pulses, which are transmitted to the evaluation computer. Once the wheel passes the axle, the magnetic flux diameter 1 becomes active again. In this way, senses the track occupancy counts the axles and sends the data to the control room. This device changes the signal, identifies the train's location, and maintains the safety. If you enjoyed this video, leave your best comment below. We'd love to share your thoughts on our community page. Thank you. Let's grow up, never stop learning.